This is CW Iowa Live.
Good morning, everyone. It's 20 minutes past 9 o'clock right now. Lou and Jackie here, along with a very special guest, as people are getting ready to party big time tonight here in Des Moines, Jackie.
That's right. Jimmy Buffett is in town with a fantastic concert over Wells Fargo Arena. But when you bring a big act like that, you have to also bring in an amazing head, starting act.
No
right?
question
to get
about
things
it.
Rocking, get the
started,
party
yep.
started. And we have that opening act.
That's
for you
my
right
job.
Now. That's your job.
Yeah. Caroline Jones in the studio with us. And what an honor it is, first of all, to have you here, and B, to have you open for a guy of the stature of Jimmy Buffett.
It is for sure. It is just that. It's an honor. I'm having a blast. We're all over the country right now, so.
That Which is wonderful great. To hear. Okay, so enough about him. We know what he's doing. How about you? Tell us about yourself and a little bit about your music.
Well, first of all, thanks for having me. Yeah. I'm a singer-songwriter. My album, Bare Feet, just came out last month, and it's
Wonderful.
My baby. I wrote all the songs. I co-produced it with Rick Wake, and he's produced Mariah Carey and Whitney Houston and Celine Dion and Trisha Yearwood. And I played all the instruments on the record except bass and drums.
Nice.
So all-inclusive.
Yes, sir.
So this really was in your head, and you got it out of your head, and boom, onto
yes,
a
Yes, it is my heart
device.
And soul and music, exactly.
How long have you been performing?
I've been performing, you know, I started singing when I was 9, and I've been performing professionally for 10 years.
Wow.
So I really love it. It's my passion.
That is amazing.
And with this new album, what are people going to experience when they listen?
Well, it's a little bit of country, a little bit of pop, a little bit of singer-songwriter. You know, I fell in love with country music when I was 17. I went to Nashville for the first time, and I went to a show at the Bluebird Cafe, which is a legendary singer-songwriter venue. Mm-hmm. And I just fell in love. I grew up in the Northeast, so I didn't grow up listening to country. And I just fell in love with that tradition of storytelling and authenticity and musicianship and craftsmanship. And so once I discovered country and incorporated that into my pop and singer-songwriter sensibilities, I felt I had found my style.
Your niche and a thing that is really setting you apart from everybody else. What does it mean to be attached to a big name like Jimmy Buffett and the exposure that you're now getting, not only doing TV and things like that, but on a big stage tonight at Wells Fargo?
Well, I'm really, really blessed to have great mentors, especially in the touring sphere. I toured all last year with the Zac Brown Band.
Yeah,
right.
And I can call Zac a mentor and a friend, and now Jimmy a mentor and a friend. And these are guys that have had decade-long careers, you know, decades and decades, and their fans have remained loyal to them throughout those decades, and it's because they inspire with their message and their lyrics and their music, and they stand for something, and their fans feel that, and so that's really taught me a lot about knowing who you are as an artist and sticking by that and treating your fans well. Yeah.
Absolutely. What do you like to write about? What do you like to sing about, especially
like
with your recent album?
I like to write a lot about kind of life from an introspective standpoint, actually. The song Bare Feet is really about living an authentic life and the person that I want to be and how I want to walk into the world. And I think that's what art does kind of at its highest purpose, is like inspire people to live better lives and to be more truly themselves.
You know, it sounds like you've been inspired by music your entire life, basically, up in the Northeast. But what were you listening to back in the Northeast before you discovered?
Well, my dad is from Memphis, so I grew up listening to a lot of Motown, soul, classic R&B, classic rock, and then my mom listened to the divas of the 90s, like Mariah and Whitney and Barbara Streisand and Celine Dion, and so it was kind of a hodgepodge of music, but all very, you know, heartfelt and soul-based.
So that was the root of where your music came
exactly,
from.
Exactly, yeah. Great melodies, you know.
That is awesome. Yeah. And how did you finally first get on the road with these big names?
Zach heard my music, I want to say about a year and a half ago. He heard my first single called Tough Guys, which I'm going to be playing later.
Okay, good.
And he just reached out and loved it. We were connected through friends of friends, and it's just been an organic, natural growth. I also spent years touring high schools and colleges in more of a philanthropic endeavor. And so I've been on the road for a bunch of years, but this is the second year that I'm on a tour of this scale. So
very nice. Besides being able to sing your songs and play your music, what do you look forward to when you hit that stage later on tonight? What gets you excited?
Oh, wow. Well, it's what I live for, honestly. I know that sounds so cheesy, but like that's the moment where I feel most like myself and I feel most on purpose. I just love the energy. I love music. I love sharing. Like, what an opportunity to be able to share your music with tonight will be like 20,000 people. Yeah. Like what a gift, like what an honor, honestly, to be able to share with that many people and hopefully inspire them, make them a fan.
Absolutely.
Now, when you first picked up a guitar and you went up on stage and you performed for the first time, do you remember how many people were out watching you?
It was in the single digits for sure. So this is a step up for sure. Yeah.
Amazing. Okay, so as we said, you're going to be hearing this glorious voice here in a few minutes on our program, CW Iowa Live, but also later on tonight, Wells Fargo Arena. Do you know when you're taking the stage?
8 o'clock.
8 o'clock. Yes. Okay. So yeah. Get there early and see what this is all about, especially with the new album, Bare Feet. If people want more details on all the great things you're doing, where should they go?
CarolineJones.com or any of my social platforms, Caroline Jones. I-N-E.
Okay, there you go.
All right, so you need to strap the guitar on and
yes.
get ready to rock and roll here, right?
Here we go.
All right, so we'll take care of a little bit of biz, and we are going to be right back. And when we come back, we'll hear this glorious voice, Caroline Jones on CW Iowa Live.